This exercise is the kettlebell clean. Pablo will make sure that when he inserts his hand into the kettlebell, that the thumb and the fingers are at the front side of the bell, that there is no space here between his hand and the bell. Do it wrong. This is not the correct way to hold the kettlebell, based on how you've been taught. Put it in. Okay, the clean, he's going to clean the kettlebell from the position you see it in just now into the rack. You rock it, and then you'll clean it up and down. From side on, from side on, from on. As you can see, the bell sits nicely on the chest. The hand's inserted correctly, and the elbow is resting on the hip. This is the back. In order to execute the clean again, Carlo will allow the bell to rotate slightly, drop down, and then he'll clean it back up. As you can see, his left hand moves with the pendulum, and it's nice and fluid. Turn side up. What Pablo won't do is this. He won't pour the bell forward and then yank it back up. Pour it forward and yank it back up. Okay. What you're finding in this position with this technique is that he's not generating enough hip drive so that the thumb can come up towards the shoulder quickly enough. He's allowing the bell to swing out too far. On the clean, he's also dropping it out too far. Front on. Once you've lifted the kettlebell up and you've wrapped it as the position you see right now, you've cleaned it up, you will then press it above the head. The opposite arm will be out for balance and the movement will be executed correctly in a full range. Back to back, side on. Key teaching point here is that the arm comes all the way back. Chris. And that Pablo could look to the right hand side and he would be able to see himself if he was looking in a mirror. Back down. Pressing to the front is incorrect. There's too much space. Back in. Always aim to make sure that the shoulder rotates fully. And as you press up, the side of the outside of the arm is the bicep, tries to touch the ear. Excellent. And stop. Relax.